Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Rosa and we're just going to dive on in and get started. I'm bringing you a Christmas extra, a Christmas bonus, a love extra. We're going to take a look and see what this person's thoughts, feelings and actions are going to be towards you during this silly season, during the festive season. This reading is for entertainment only, so take what speaks, leave what doesn't, guys. This reading too, I should mention, is specific to all air signs. So Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, this is your read. It is for entertainment only, meaning it's not a personal read. But if you find the messages resonate, then feel free to let me know by hitting that like button. That would be greatly appreciated. Okay. Let's take a look and see how this person is, well, what this person is thinking when it comes to you. What are their thoughts of you right now? So spirit, angels and guides. Okay, I'll take the, okay, three have landed. Let's have a look. We've got the world. We have the King of Cups in reverse and we've got the Knight of Coins. Okay. Okay, so with the Knight of Coins, this person is thinking that they need to take their time. Okay, they need to take their time. They need to go slow. There's no need to rush here. I do feel like this person is taking a more logical, practical stance on this. Like their thoughts of you are more... it's more practical. It's like, what's practical here? What's doable here? They're thinking with the King of Cups in reverse that you're not interested in them. I feel like with the world here, this person sees you or views you as maybe the one, or they see you in a high light. This person may be even putting you up on some kind of a pedestal. They may think that you're too good for them. Yeah, because I'm seeing the world like this is someone putting someone up on a pedestal here. They could be viewing you as someone who is detached emotionally or maybe emotionally unavailable at this time. So, which is why they're taking a more realistic view on this. They're looking at this through a realistic lens. Does that make sense, guys? They're getting real with themselves. So there's this element of needing to take their time. They're not in a hurry here. Let's get some clarity on the Knight of Coins, shall we? Spirit, angels and guides, can we get some clarity around this Knight of Coins? Six of Pentacles. Now, in this Six of Pentacles, there's three people. It could be that they're viewing you as emotionally detached because it could be that you're in a relationship with someone else right now, or maybe you're busy with other things right now. Okay, the Six of Pentacles is the card of service. So it could be a work situation too for some of you. I mean, it could be like they need to take their time because it could be inappropriate, especially if you know each other through work. So if this person is thinking that they need to take a more practical stance on things, I see with the Six of Pentacles that they want to come in and help you or offer to help you here. So they're thinking this, right? They're not taking action on this, but they're thinking, how can I help my air sign? I want to come in. I want to show them that I'm sort of like interested, or I want to do something for them. Let's get some clarity on this world card. Eight of Wands in reverse. Things right now, they're seeing things not moving. They're seeing things as stagnant. It could be due to some kind of distance that is put between you. For some of you, this person cannot travel to come towards you. Okay, they see this as like hopeless because they need to travel to come towards you. Maybe this person cannot travel to come towards you at this time. Let's get some clarity on the King of Cups in reverse. We've got two cards that flipped out here, the Lovers and the Justice. Yeah, it could be that this person views you as maybe being married or committed to someone else. Maybe there's another option here. But they view you as being committed to someone else. Interesting. Let's take a look and see how this person feels towards you. Five of Cups. We can see in these Five of Cups, this person feels very, very sad. Okay, they're experiencing some kind of loss or grief here. Maybe they've missed a wonderful opportunity here with you, the High Priestess. I feel with the High Priestess that this person is, they're hiding their feelings. Okay, I don't feel like they're talking about their feelings. Their feelings are kept a secret right now. Wow, we've got two fives in this spread. There was some kind of falling out, some kind of fight, some kind of argument. They definitely feel that there is tension here between you. They feel like there's some kind of a battle here. I feel that they're grieving this relationship. They're grieving the loss. They're grieving some kind of a loss here. And right now with the High Priestess, they're keeping their feelings to themselves. They're not showing you how they feel. You might be tuning into this reading going, oh, that is so not them. But on an emotional level, wow, it's a different story. I feel like with the High Priestess, they've got some kind of like poker face on. But definitely here, they're experiencing grief or loss when it comes to you. See this person, they're holding two cups. They're still holding on to some kind of emotion that they had towards you or they had with you. But we see three cups broken here. So they've clearly lost out. You may have moved on. You may be in a relationship with someone else. They may view you with the Justice card as more balanced. And it's like they've gotten their karma here. But they feel tension here, okay? So let's get some clarity on the Five of Swords. Spirit, angels, and guides, can we get some clarity on this Five of Swords? Five of Pentacles in reverse. That's three fives and five in... The number five alone speaks to change. Okay, changes, transition. This person feels that they have lost you. When the Five of Pentacles is in the upright, this is someone walking away. This is someone giving the cold shoulder. This is someone feeling rejected. They don't like that feeling. They do not like that feeling. Right now, you may be giving this person the cold shoulder. They're feeling that. They feel like they want to come towards you. maybe they are the ones that gave you the cold shoulder. Now they want to turn things around. They want to come back around and they want to give you attention. They want to give you what they didn't in the past. If they gave you the cold shoulder, if they shut you out, like you may feel like they're doing the opposite of that. So let's see what this person's actions. Okay, these cards fell out, so clearly they don't want to be in the pile. Let's see what this person's actions will be towards you. The Hanging Man in reverse. We see after a period of time of this person not doing anything, but they want to take action towards you. Okay. Ooh, Ten of Cups. Seven of Coins in reverse. So clearly here with the Seven of Coins in reverse, this person has lost out in some way. Maybe you had the Ten of Cups with this person. Okay, maybe at one point you had the Ten of Cups with this person, but they didn't invest. You know, Seven of Coins in reverse is like, well, I'm not going to invest any more energy into this marriage, into this relationship, into this commitment. They kind of want this. They want the Ten of Cups with you, but without having to really put a lot of energy into it. Even with the Hanging Man in reverse, this person wants to take action towards you, but it doesn't tell me anything. It's like, okay, you want to take action towards Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, but what are you going to do? Because with the Seven of Coins in reverse, this is still telling you that this person isn't really prepared to do a whole lot. I mean, at the end of the day, when we look at this Hanging Man, it looks like an acrobat to me. And I see this as a bit of a joker. So let's get some clarity on this Hanging Man. Yeah, look at this. I feel like it's hot air, full of air. Queen of Wands in reverse. This is someone who's really lazy. They're not willing to put in a whole lot of action right now. And the action moves that they're going to take tell me here with the Queen of Wands that it's selfish moves. Sorry, but I'm calling it how it is. Let's look at the Seven of Coins in reverse, which again, that Seven of Coins is telling me why I don't want to do too much. I laugh at this. The Seven of Pentacles in reverse to clarify the Seven of Coins in reverse. This is the same card, you guys. Like, this person doesn't want to put a whole lot of action into this. They're not really, really doing a lot. Let's get some clarity on the Ten of Cups. They want the Ten of Cups with you, but what are they doing about it? What are they doing about it? It's laughable. I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at the situation. Four of Pentacles in reverse. Okay. So I feel like when it comes to this Ten of Cups, they're not really serious because the Four of Pentacles in reverse is a letting go energy. It's like, you know what? I'll give it my best shot. Whatever comes, comes. Whatever doesn't, doesn't. Does that make sense, you guys? I just feel like with the Four of Pentacles, they're not holding on. They're not taking it seriously. Yeah, I feel like I just get the sense that this person's a bit of a joker, to be honest. It's a bit of a joke. They're not even taking their actions seriously. They could just be throwing it out there, seeing what comes of it. I'm really sorry, guys. I want to say don't get your hopes up with this person. So there we have it. That's your reading. I hope this helped. Until next time, take care. Bye for now.